Well, hello, everybody, and welcome to another in our series of very interesting conversations on Sikh studies. And today we have a real treat with Dr. Balwinderjit Kaur Bhatti from the Punjabi University in Punjab, in India. And we're really excited to have Indian scholarship on Sikh studies as a part of this conversation, which, as you know, has focused on Sikh studies in North America and UK. And the idea for this series came from my good friend, Narendra Kapani, who is the founder of the Sikh Foundation, among many other distinguished aspects of his career as a physicist and a scientist and as an art collector and a philanthropist. And shortly before his death in December, Narendra asked me to moderate this series because he and I established the first conference on Sikh studies in North America in 1976, many years ago. And he said, okay, it's time again to look at the state of Sikh studies in North America and the UK. And that's what we focused on for all of these conversations. But from time to time, reference is made to the way Sikh studies is taught in Punjab, in India. And so we thought it would be wonderful to have some spokespersons from the Punjab to join us. And we're really delighted today to have Dr. Balwinderjit Kaur Bhatti from Punjabi University. You know, there's several distinguished universities in the Punjab. There's Guru Nanak Dev University in Amritsar, with which I was once affiliated. There is Punjab University in Chandigarh, where I taught for some years. And then there's Punjabi University in Patiala, which is equally as distinguished and has a great reputation of its own. And so today we're really pleased to have Dr. Bhatti with us to tell us a little bit about how Sikh studies is organized at Punjabi University. And then also tell us a little bit about her own very interesting work on Sikh history. She's a historian and deals with, just looking over her CV, and she writes about everything. She has covered Sikh history from Guru Granth Sahib to the Gadar Party and everything in between. So I'm really interested in our conversation today. So Dr. Bhatti, welcome to this series.
Sir, before I start my discussion and conversation, I would like to thank all the members of the Sikh Foundation International, especially my thanks to you and to Dr. Tanmeet Gujral. And I want to tell you, the Sikh study is being taught in our university in many departments. I will.
That's what I understand. There's not just one department of Sikh studies. There's Sikh studies in Punjabi language. There's Sikh studies in history. There's Sikh studies in religious studies.
In the campus, there are three departments which directly relate to the Sikh studies. And our department is history department and Punjab historical studies department. Our department, my department is Punjab historical study department. And this department is one of the earliest department in the university. My department, I want to say something about my department.
Yeah, please.
Indirectly, this department is also related with the Sikh studies and also related with the Sikh history. This department was established by an eminent historian, Dr. Ganda Singh, in 1963, with the objective of
I remember Dr. Ganda Singh very well. I've met him on many occasions. Yeah. And I'm a great admirer of his work. He is indeed one of the pillars of the field of Sikh studies. Yes. And you are so honored to have him as the founder of your department.
Yes, sir. I also feel honored in this department. Dr. Ganda Singh has done a lot of works on Punjab history, on Sikh history also. And the objective of our department is to promote the research, to promote the regional history, to promote the Sikh history. The regular feature of our department is to organize Punjab History Conference, which was instituted by Dr. Ganda Singh in 1965. And continuously it is going on. And every year, the theme of the conference is very important, mostly related with the Sikh history, with the history of Punjab, sometimes with the anniversary of the Sikh gurus. For example, 2 or 3 years back, we have organized conference on the 350th anniversary of Guru Gobind Singh. And the theme of the conference was Guru Gobind Singh. And in 2019, we have organized the conference, the session of the conference on the 550th anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev. 550th anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev, and many scholars, many researchers, many Sikh historians have participated in this conference. And last year, we have organized the conference on the 400th birth anniversary of Shri Guru Tegh Bahadur, the ninth guru of the Sikhs.
Yes.
But during the pandemic, during the COVID-19, we could not organize this conference. So our department has played a main role in the field of Sikh studies. Sir, I want to say something about this department. Every year in the conference, the paper presented in this conference, we released the proceeding of this conference, or in this proceeding, many research papers, important research papers presented by the scholars from different parts of the countries, from different universities, not from India even the South Asian countries, from Pakistan, from Bangladesh, and from many other countries, the participants come in this conference and presented the paper, and we release the proceeding every year. For example, in 2019, 253 delegates came in this conference and released the proceeding, many important papers on Guru Nanak, the philosophy of Guru Nanak, the philosophy of Sikhism. It's a very prestigious department in the university. And there is an other department, history department. Our department is a research department. History department is a teaching department where the MA, MPhil, and PhD are being taught.
Yes, and you're the head of the department, I believe.
What's the pardon?
You're the head of the department.
At present, I am working as a professor in the department. After 19th, I am not head. I headed the department continuously 8 years. I have organized 8 conferences successfully. And many eminent historians, just like Professor Irfan Habib, Professor Shireen Musmi, Professor J.S. Garewal, Dr. Kirpal Singh, many eminent historians has come in our conference successfully. From the JNU in Delhi, Professor Maridullah Mukherjee, Professor Aditya Mukherjee, Professor Pagwan Josh, they are the general resident of our conferences.
Well, these are very eminent names indeed. Very distinguished scholars.
Yes, very distinguished scholars. Okay. And the other achievements of our department is a very prestigious journal, Punjab Past and Present, was started by Dr. Gandas.
Yes. So, Dr. Bhatti, let me ask a question. I hope Dr. Bhatti is still with us. I don't see her picture on the screen. But if you can hear my question, how is Sikh studies then? I know there's a Department of Religious Studies at Patiala, at the Punjabi University in Patiala. I think Punjabi University is the first university in India, maybe still the only one, to have a Department of Comparative Religion. And yes, which was established many years ago. Professor Wilfred Cantwell Smith of Harvard helped to inaugurate that department. And it was really quite an extraordinary achievement, and still is. So is Sikh studies also taught in the Comparative Religion Department?
Yes.
And if so, how is it taught differently? How is it different in religious studies than Sikh studies taught in your department in history?
Actually, in this university, there are three departments related with the Sikh studies directly. One department that is most important department is Department of Religious Study, right? Religious Study Department, which was established in 1967.
Right.
And this department was established in 1967, and its foundation stone was laid by then the president, Dr. Zakir Hussain.
Yes.
This department is dedicated to the memory of our 10th guru, Shri Guru Gobind Singh.
Mm-hmm.
And this building, you have visited our university, and have you seen the building?
Yes, I've seen this. It's very beautiful, architecturally. Very beautiful.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It is a logo of the university, and this building has named Guru Gobind Singh Bhavan.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very attractive building. Very attractive building.
But how is Sikh studies taught differently in religious studies?
Yes.
In your department?
Yes. Know about my department or religious department? What is the difference between my department and the religious study department?
What is taught in religious studies about Sikh studies that is not taught in your department?
Okay. Sir, actually, indirectly, our department is also related with the Sikh studies, because our department is totally a research department, right? In the research department, the students who have registered with us, registered with the faculty, they have chosen their PhD topic mostly on Sikh studies. Sikh study means on, for example, the contribution of Guru Nanak Dev Ji, the philosophy of Guru Nanak Dev. These are the PhD topics.
In religious studies, the emphasis is more on the teachings, on the philosophy, on the theology, and on the ideas rather than the historical trends within the tradition.
Sir, in the religious studies, this department offers two MA for the students. One is MA of Masters of Sikh Studies, and other is Masters of Religious Studies.
Mm-hmm.
In Sikh studies, the course, the syllabus of only related with the Sikhism, with the Sikh ethics, with the Sikh theology, with the Sikh scriptures. And in the Masters of in the Masters of Religious Studies, the syllabus is, the courses is related with the five religion in the world. That is Hinduism, Sikhism, Buddhism, Islam, and Christianity.
I see.
In the Masters of Religious Study, there are comparative study. Right. Comparative study, for example, what is a comparative study of Sikhism and Buddhism?
I see.
The condition of women in the Buddhism and in the Sikhism are comparative study. These are the topics on which the researcher are going on.
I have so many questions to ask, but Dr. Bhatia, but let me tell the people who are watching us right now that you can ask questions by putting your questions in. There's a Q&A at the bottom of your Zoom screen, and that's like a chat, and you can just type out your questions. And then in the last half of our discussion, I will ask as many of these questions I can to Dr. Bhatia, but of course, I have lots of questions of my own. let me ask this question first. How many students do you have? Do you have a lot of graduate students in both history and religious studies? Are there many students?
Sir, actually my department is totally a research department, but in the religious study department, I think near about 50 seats for masters. 50 seats for master's religious study, 50 seats for Sikh studies.
Mm-hmm.
Because I got the information from their department. Because in my department is totally a research department. Somebody asking me the question about my publication, I want to tell you, sir, my area of research is medieval Punjab in general and Sikh history in particular.
You have a very distinguished record. I know, I've seen your publications.
I have my own book on Shri Guru Granth Sahib, Social Concern.
Right.
And three books are in press.
One on the Udasis, I think, which is an interesting subject. You have a book on the Udasis.
My thesis, my PhD. Udasis, they're
asking about.
Okay. I have worked on my research work of PhD is on a source. A source is named Udasi Bodh. It is related with the Udasi sect.
I see.
And it is also under press. And there are my two books on Guru Nanak.
Yes.
Those are also under press, under publication. Soon it will be released, and near about 40 research papers are published in different journals, in different books, and in different proceedings.
Uh-huh. Well, very, very impressive indeed. Dr. Bhatia, I want to ask you one question that has come up during our conversations with Sikh scholars in the United States and the UK. Many of them are working in areas that are not a part of what I would regard as traditional Sikh studies, not only on Sikh history and the text on the Guru Granth Sahib, but many scholars work on Sikh art or Sikh music, or the role of Sikh communities in diaspora. Are there studies like this within Punjabi University also? Can you study Sikh art? Can you study Sikh music? Can you study some of these other aspects of Sikh culture that are different from history and from religious ideas?
Sir, actually, the mandate of our university was to promote the Punjabi language, literature, and culture. So in our university, there is a department of arts, fine arts, dance, music, Gurmat Sangeet, and there are research on Rabab, Pai Mardana, Guru Shabad. The research are continuously going on. In there is an independent department of Gurmat Sangeet. You have learned the very famous name of Dr. Gurnam Singh.
Yes.
Who has established this department? I think nowadays he is also in America.
Yes.
Now he has retired.
So in a way, the whole of Punjabi University encompasses Sikh studies. I mean, you can study aspects of Sikhism in almost any department in the university. Is that not right?
No, sir, in the religious department, there is another department, very important department. That department is Encyclopedia of Sikhism.
Well, Dr. Harbhajan Singh.
Yes. Dr. Harbhajan Singh has established this department, and he was the chief editor of Encyclopedia of Sikhism. It's a very prestigious department also. And research of Sikh studies are going on there. In this department, there are two professors in Encyclopedia of Sikhism. And the research of Sikh studies going on.
Well, Dr. Harbhajan Singh was a great scholar indeed. I had the privilege of hosting him at Berkeley many years ago when he
was a great scholar, sir.
Yeah. I believe recently you have had a conference with his daughter, my friend Nikki Guninder Kaur.
Yes, she is my friend of mine also, Nikki Guninder. She has visited our department few years back. She has delivered a lecture.
I think
by our department.
I think you share an interest that she has that I think many people listening will be interested in, and that is the role of women in Sikh history and in Sikh culture in general. Can you say something about that?
Yes, role of women in Sikh history?
Yes.
Yes, yes, sir. Lot of research has done on this topic in history department. For example, Mata Gujri, Mai Pago, Bebe Nanki, all the women related with the Sikh history, the mothers of Sikh gurus. There are most of a lot of research work on these women. There are Sikh personalities, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, Sikh missiles. There are research works on these topics. Sikh missiles, Pangi missiles, Aluwalia missiles, Nakai missiles, the topic on Ranjit Singh. Sir, I have done my MPhil on the period of Ranjit Singh. My topic was at that time, the Dharmarth grants during the period of Sikh history. For example, 1750 to 1850, during the time of Ranjit Singh, during the reign of Ranjit Singh, I have done my work. And on PhD, I have done my work on a manuscript. And I have an interest in Sikh history, so that I have already told you my two books on Guru Nanak. One on Guru Tegh Bahadur. These are under press. And my one book is on Shri Guru Granth Sahib, published.
And your students, and, are are your students equally men and women? Are both men and women in your MA and MPhil and PhD programs?
Sir, mixed students. Half are girls and men and half are females. The research scholars, equal research scholars are there.
And equal numbers are more men than women or more women than men?
More or less, not equal, more or less. Okay, professor has taken 8 scholar at a time.
Has a limit.
This is a limit by UGC, right?
Mm-hmm. And of those 8, how many are women and how many men?
Equal.
Equal.
I think women are in high number.
Oh, okay.
I think so.
Well, that's interesting. That's good for the field. It's interesting to know.
Yes.
So, Dr. Pathy, can I ask you about your own personal interest in Sikh studies? How did you get interested in this? You could have gone into medicine and become a doctor. You could have become a scientist. You could have studied many things, but you decided to study Sikh history. Why?
Sir, actually, my specialization is of medieval Punjab, because in MA we have studied every period, that is 18th century, that is 19th century, even the modern history, 20th century. Right. But my interest is on the Sikh history, because my husband, he's a retired professor from university in Punjabi language. And before 40 years, he has done his MPhil on War March. Yes, and I also love Gurbani, Sikh gurus. I also, so my interest is on Sikh history. I have the research papers totally on Sikh history, totally on gurus. I love Gurbani. I faith in Gurbani.
Actually, that's a question. I want to turn to some of the questions. Govinder Singh.
Also I sing Gurbani by Kirtan. I have interest.
Well, that is interesting. That is exactly what Govinder wants to know. He wants to know how
you belong to a Sikh family. I belong to a Sikh family. Yeah. When I was in school time, at that time I was participated in the Kirtan, daily, yeah, in Gurdwaras.
Uh-huh.
Yes. So I have interest in Sikh history.
Yes, you could have been interested in Sikh philosophy, or you could have been interested in the performance of Gurbani or Sikh music, but you chose history, and which is demanding, because it requires a lot of language study and language preparation. You can't just rely on contemporary Punjabi. You have to deal with sources that are many centuries old, and language that is different, of course, many centuries ago than it is at present. And then in the Guru Granth Sahib, you have to deal with Raj and other language backgrounds. Was that difficult to learn all of these different languages and to find these sources?
Actually, sir, I have done my research on a source. Actually, this source is during the time of Ranjit Singh. Uh-huh. Actually, Yes. There is a research on the sources. Our university has lot of sources, Gurmukhi sources, sources of sources of 18th century, sources of 19th century. Mm-hmm. For example, sources of 17th century, sources of 17th century. For example, Varanpai Gurdas, Senapati Gursoba, sources of 18th century, sources of 19th century. For example, there are many sources, many Sikh sources, just like Gyani Gyan Singh Tawarikh Guru Khalsa, Gyani Gyan Singh Pant Prakash, Ratan Singh Pangu Prachin Pant Prakash, Guru Kiya Sakhiya. There are many sources lying in our university, in the library of Dr. Ganda Singh, reference library.
Well, Kavinder Singh actually has a question about that, and that is regarding the sources. You say yes. That some of this is in the library of Dr. Ganda Singh, which is really a wonderful resource. But yes. Isn't it also necessary then for you to go out and to try to find manuscripts and to try to locate different sources that may not be available in the university?
Yes.
So do you have to go on a hunt to try to find these sources?
Sir, actually there are number of in our university, but actually I did my whole education from GNT University Amritsar. And when I was doing my MPhil, I have to go the National Archives of India, State Archives of Patiala. I got the material from these archives, and then I had done my work. So there are many sources. It depends upon the topic which you have chosen for research.
There are a couple of questions. I didn't mean to cut you off. But there are a couple of questions about that would interest our viewers, who are most of whom are living in the United States and the UK, and whether there are opportunities for foreign students, from students from the UK and the United States, to come to Punjabi University and study. Mohinder Gulati wants to know whether there are short courses, maybe 1 or 2 weeks, where someone could come from the United States or Canada and the UK and study at Punjabi University. Are there opportunities like that?
Yes, sir. There is another department in the university which relates with the Sikh scripture and which is relates with the Sikh history directly. That department is Shri Guru Granth Sahib Department. And in this department, this department offers two courses. One is for diploma for 1 year course
in Sikh theology.
And another is a certificate course for 3 months.
I see.
So many people come and attend the 3 month course, certificate course, which is totally related with the reading of Shri Guru Granth Sahib. That is so, very important department.
So it's a 3 month course. Having lived in the Punjab, I hope it's not in the summer, but it's a 3 month course. Sometime during the year where foreigners can come and study. Is it taught in English or in Punjabi? Is the language for the instruction in English or is it in Punjabi?
Sir, mostly our all courses are being taught in Punjabi language, because the mandate of our university is to promote Punjabi language, because this university is named on the, this is the second university in the world which naming
named after the language.
Which is the name on the language, Punjabi language.
So Punjabi University.
Every professor try to teach in social sciences and in religious departments in Punjabi.
Well, fortunately, some of the people watching know Punjabi or want to learn it and want to improve their Punjabi, and this would be a great opportunity. Sonia Dami has a question about whether foreign students can enroll in the master's program or the PhD program. Do you have to be a resident of India? Or if you come from the United States or Canada and you know enough Punjabi to, you know, follow the classes, are you allowed to enroll?
There are many students, they came for PhD from Ethiopia in our university.
So there are some international students on campus?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, that's good to know. Let me ask another question. Kulvinder Singh has another question about the Sikh diaspora. This is of course great interest to those of us who live in the United States and Canada and UK, to understand the Sikh community and the Sikhi and the practices of Sikhism in outside of the Punjab in different parts of the world. Is that also an interest of some people in your university, maybe in anthropology? Is there an interest in the global spread of Sikhism, the diaspora of Sikhism?
Sir, in our university, there is a department of diaspora, study of diaspora.
The whole department on diaspora studies.
Yes. And many students, many students are researching on diaspora. There is a lot of work on diaspora. Many theses are lying there on diaspora. On Sikh diaspora. Yes.
And in general, maybe I can ask you your personal opinion. Do you think that in diaspora, the practice of Sikhism is different from it is in the Punjab, or is it all the same? Has the faith and the practices continue in the same way in diaspora as in the Punjab?
Sir, I think there is no any difference. One student who has chosen the topic on Sikh diaspora, he is working as the student working in the religious study, student researching on the religious studies. I think there is no any difference.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, that's good to know. There's a question about the, I think a lot of us are interested in the Kisan Andolan that is going on today. This is around the world, people know about this Andolan and they are concerned about the future of the Kisan movement and about the farmers in the Punjab. Is this a concern to your university also, or is this is just politics? but it affects everyone, and it certainly affects the Sikh community perhaps more than others.
Sir, being a Punjabi, I live in Punjab, so yeah. I support the farmers.
Yes.
Just good. I have just me on, and my daughter and my husband visited at Singhu border, support them, offer good. Them, and help them. And I support their slogan. They are struggling at least from 8 months. But there is no effect on our government. You know very well our PM about his policy. Many students, sir, this is the major problem in Punjab in these days. Many students applied for study in America, in Canada, in other countries. Why? Because there is no any employment for them.
Mm-hmm.
There is unemployment. The government don't think about the common people,
mm-hmm.
about the youth. There is a major problem in Punjab at mm-hmm. this time.
Yes.
So it
affects all aspects of life, as you say. It's not just an issue of farmers' employment and land holdings. It's an issue of the community and the future of the community and the health of the community. So it touches all aspects of life. Right.
The people of Punjab, if no farmers, no food. Food is
right.
necessary
right.
for survival.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. All Punjabi, even Punjabi University, even the student of Punjabi University, even the teachers of Punjabi University supported the farmer agitation, spoke in the favor of this agitation.
Yes. That's good to know. Well, we also support the movement, even those of us in the United yes. States.
Yes, sir. I am happy to listen to this.
So there is a question about your connection with scholars outside of India. You mentioned Professor Nikki Singh Gunindarkar, but you also, I think, have had contact with other scholars from outside of India. They have come to Punjabi University. Have you also gone abroad to UK or Canada or the United States to meet with scholars?
Sir, actually last year in 2019, in the month of May, mm-hmm. I have attended the Sikh study conference that was on Guru Nanak Dev, on the 50th anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev. And I know Dr. Pishara Singh, Dr.
Yes.
Upinder Jait, Dr. Tanveer, Dr. Uminder. I know all the scholars. I have presented the paper there. Nikki Gunindar was also there. She was also there. I felt very good myself to attend this conference. University of California, Riverside, Dr. Pishara yeah. Singh, he's yeah. on the chair, and he has yeah. organized this conference. That conference was well organized, and
yes.
I attend this conference. Yes.
Wonderful. Well, I think it's so important to have this international connection, and for scholars of Sikh studies in the UK and Canada and United States to be in connection with the scholars of the Punjab and vice
yes.
versa.
Yes, sir.
I'm delighted to hear about that. Well, there's a question about your students. You talked about employment within the Punjab in general. But what about the employment of your students? You have a lot of MA and PhD students. Are they able to find jobs after they graduate? Are they able to be able to teach in a university or colleges?
Uh, Sir, this is a question of unemployment in Punjab, also in India. Many students, many scholars are jobless. There is no any opportunity. No any opportunity. The government never think about these youth. If in the Punjab, the student, the scholar who has passed his NET, his or her NET and her PhD, if he got the job, then why the youth moving in Canada or America? Why? Because there is no job. My daughter, she is my daughter, sitting with me. She is a topper in BA, in MA, and NET qualified, and enrolled for PhD. But there is no any job. And she is a national winner 3 times in the field of performing arts. She is MA in classical dance. She is an artist. But there is no any job. And this is a problem for me. I am thinking whether I should send her in the abroad or not. Tell me what I have to do.
No, it's a there serious is no any, it's a serious problem.
No any opportunity.
No, I understand it's a serious problem.
Yes.
And so many of your problem. And so many of your can we say hi to your daughter? Hi. Thank you for helping this conversation.
Not a problem, sir.
So for many students who have a PhD in Punjab history and Sikh history, it's not easy to find a job in a college teaching.
So there is no job, permanent job, no grade. Even the teachers are working in the colleges, in the universities on 10,000 per month.
So I have
Sorry.
I have two large Yeah, finish your thought, because I have two large questions to ask.
So during pandemic, during corona, during COVID-19, actually from 1.5 years, there is no job, no opportunity.
Yeah, and this has been a difficult time.
It is a setback. It's a setback on economy of our country, on employment, and on the artist. Everything is stuck off. Even in America and Canada, there are also.
Yes, that's true. But I know India has been affected, particularly in the last couple months, with this horrible wave of the new variant of COVID now, it's just been devastating. We've seen tragic pictures coming out of India. Yes. Has your own university been affected? Have been faculty and students, have they, some of them suffered with the COVID disease in Punjabi University?
Yes, sir. Some of the teachers, the students affected by corona. They are positive, and I think university closed for some time.
And now, have your classes been on Zoom like this?
Yes, online classes are going till now. Mm-hmm. Still now. In these days, even exams are conducted online. Online. Mm-hmm. Everything is on online. Nothing is offline.
Have you found it difficult to teach online?
Yes, because there is a problem of internet. Thank God now internet is going on in during this conversation.
Yeah, right.
There is no benefit, yes, in India.
Yeah, right, right. Yeah. So constantly you're starting and stopping and trying to reconnect. Yeah, I can understand the difference. Even when it works well, it's not easy. So my first of all, the question that I ask every panelist, and that is, you know, how you see the field of Sikh studies, because at Punjabi University, where Punjabi language is premier and is the medium of instruction, one can find Sikh studies, I would imagine, in almost every department, anthropology or sociology, as well as history. And so in your imagination, when you hear the word Sikh studies, does that mean all of this, or does it just mean the history and teachings of the gurus and the history of Sikh tradition? Is Sikh studies everything, or is it, you see it in a narrow sense or a broad sense?
In the you know, the masters of Sikh, the syllabus of the masters of Sikh studies, sir, according to my views, the Sikh studies philosophy of Sikhism, the Sikh studies start with the Mool Mantra, with the Guru Shabad, with the scriptures, with the Gurbani and Shabad by all the gurus. I know. You know also Shri Guru Granth Sahib, the Sikh Sakrit. In Sikh studies, there are the study of Mool Mantra, the study of Shabad, the study of Sikh personalities, the study of Sikh gurus, the study of Sikh institutions like institution, just for example, Manji Pratha, Masand Pratha, started by our guru. All the things are in the study of faith. I think so. It is my views, but you know very well.
Well, no, that's why I'm asking you. So as I understand it, you see Sikh studies grounded, of course, in the Guru Granth Sahib and the traditions of Sikhism, but you see it encompassing all aspects of Sikhi, all aspects of culture and life, and including art and music and culture social interaction. You see it in a narrow sense grounded in the tradition, but also in a broad sense encompassing all of these other fields as well. Is that a correct interpretation of the way in which you see the field of Sikh studies?
Yes, sir. In Sikh study, there is a study of Gurmat Sangeet.
Yeah.
Gurmat Sangeet is a recitation of Gurbani.
Right.
Recitation so of
it's grounded Gurbani, but also broad. Yeah, right. So since we have a short amount of time, let me ask about the future of the program. What is the future of? Do you see your program expanding in Punjabi University? Or let me ask it this way. How would you like to see it different in 5 years from now or 10 years from now? How would you like to see either your department or the Sikh studies in Punjabi University develop?
Sir, I think the work done on Sikh studies, it will be the beneficial in our coming generation. Our coming generation will know about our culture, about our music, about our Sikhism, or they should know about this. They will read the work which was done on the six studies. I think the future of six studies is very bright. Mm-hmm. I think the coming generation.
Mm-hmm. And do you think all mm-hmm. students should study six studies in Punjabi University? Should it be required?
Yes, ki. Yes.
Do you think is it currently required? I think in Punjabi University there's expectation of comparative religion, but
according to my views, mm-hmm. if we live in Punjab, if we belong in Punjabi, if we mm-hmm. speak in Punjabi language, if we love our Sikh gurus, we should know about the Sikh gurus, about the Sikh studies, about the Sikhism, about the Sikh theology. We should know. We must know.
But you've covered so much in your research. But what are your future plans now for what is the after these books that are in press, what is the next project?
Sir, actually, in the department, I have told you already, our regular feature is to organize history conference and editing of the research papers, editing of the papers of the Punjab past and present, and after completion of the work of these two books, I will read more and more, and I will do work on any other topic relating with the Sikh history and related with the Sikh.
Well, one of the projects that you are working on now is on Sikh historians, the people who study Sikh history, and will that result in a book or an archive of some sort?
I have no any project to do the work because I am busy in my books at this time, at present time. In future, I will think about the work, what I have to do on the work of historians. There is a few days back, we have select topic for a student, that is the contribution of Shromani Gurdwara Prabandhak Committee and contribution of Gurcharan Singh Tora, the president of the SCBC. And just like these, the other topics are the Sikh personalities, the work will done on the Sikh personalities also. And then I choose any project. Mm-hmm. Yes. Then, after 2 years, I am going to be retired.
Oh, well, you know, retirement is a wonderful opportunity to work on new books.
Yes.
Most of scholars, you know, never really retire. We are just so happy now to be free from all of the duties of a department and duties of teaching that now we can do our own research and write our own books. and is that also your plan?
Sir, actually, I started my journey in this university in 2007. Earlier, I have been working as a lecturer in a college. I taught 20th year to all classes of bachelor and MA also. So I started my research work in 2007. In 2012, I was working as a head of department, or I was very busy during these 8 years, to organize conference, to release the proceeding, to release the journal. And there are so many works. I have worked very hard as a head.
Well, you deserve a break, there's no question, but I'm sure you have other plans for research. You know, I was in Chandigarh before the pandemic and met with my old friend, Graywall, Dr. Jagtar Graywall. And Graywall now is in his 90s and he's still doing research. And he's still doing writing. He's revising his book on Guru Nanak in history. And so he has never stopped, never stopped. And I have a feeling that you will never stop either.
Yes, sir. Now at the age of about, I think now he's above 90.
Yeah.
And still he is working.
Yes.
sir, at the time, in the 80s, when I have done my MA from GND University, Amritsar, he was my teacher.
Oh, wonderful.
At that time.
Yes. I knew him as a young man back in, I first met him, I think, 1967. That was many years ago. Yes. At a Punjab history conference, yes, in Chandigarh. And he's still a young man, even though he's in his 90s. And I'm sure that when you and I are in our 90s, we will also still be working on something. And I hope we may not be as productive as he has been, but we will continue to be working on something. Well, Dr. Pathy, it's been such a pleasure talking with you and to getting to know you a little bit as a person, but also about all of the interesting things that are happening at Punjabi University. Punjabi University really is a wonderful resource for the teaching of Sikh studies and the field of Sikh studies, as are the other major universities in the Punjab. Punjab University, my old university, of course, does wonderful work in that field, as does Guru Nanak Dev University, where you got your PhD in Amritsar. So there are many wonderful resources in the Punjab for people who are interested in continuing serious study in the field of Sikh studies, and you've helped to enlarge our understanding about all of these things and to get to know you and your work much better. So I want to thank you for joining us today. It's been such a great pleasure, and thank all of you for watching us, and to be sure to tune in for the next in our discussions, which will be in a few weeks. We're taking something of a summer break, but we will continue our discussion before too long. Bye-bye, everybody.